Been using the Galaxy Watch Active 2 for almost a month now, and I want to give you my final thoughts and opinions about this device. What I'm going to do is break this down into three sections, the first being design, the second being operating system, and the third being overall functionality. So starting off with design, the watch I have here is the aluminum aqua black model. It's very nice. You have Corning Gorilla Glass on the front and back, a solid aluminum casing, and the buttons on the side are tactile and responsive. One thing I do want to mention is that the Galaxy Watch that I reviewed last year had this issue with the back button where it was kind of loose. I don't get that with the Galaxy Watch Active 2. Everything feels nice and well built. The speaker is loud. I've been rough with this watch for the last couple of weeks, and I don't see any scratches on the screen, so I am impressed overall with the design of the Galaxy Watch Active 2. If I had to knock Samsung for anything, it would be that I would love to see them include a solid black aluminum version. The aqua black is more of a dark blue. Now, I know you get a solid black stainless steel, but I wasn't able to get that one at launch because it wasn't available at my local Best Buy. However, I would love to see a solid black aluminum model as well. And to finish off in this section, let's talk about the display. I think Samsung has done another good job at making a sharp, crisp, colorful display. It's bright and outdoors, and I gave the original Galaxy Watch a knock because I thought the pixel density wasn't high enough. It's the same pixel density on this watch. However, I think not having that physical bezel just makes it seem sharper. I don't know if it's some type of placebo effect for me, but I do think that this is a great display. Now, moving on to the second section of this review, let's talk about the operating system. I think Samsung has done another good job with the Tizen 4 operating system. Everything from the quick pull-down menu to going through notifications and widgets, everything feels buttery smooth, and I think that's attributed to the digital bezel that's been added to the Galaxy Watch Active 2. And I do have to admit that it took me a few days to get really used to it. I was used to a physical bezel, and having that removed and having a digital bezel felt kind of awkward at first, but I do see some benefits with having a digital bezel over a physical bezel. One would be that there's no moving mechanical parts for some type of failure later on down the road, and the other one would be that it looks a little bit more sleeker on the wrist, at least in my opinion. Now, I know I could have put that back in the last section with design, but I feel like the operating system with the digital bezel makes this watch feel smooth and fluid and fast. And I didn't notice any lag or any hiccups with the operating system in general. Going from settings or applications and widgets, everything felt really snappy and quick. So overall, within the month of testing this operating system, I feel like Samsung has done a really good job with Tizen 4. Everything felt buttery smooth. And overall, I was just impressed with the operating system in general. Now, the third section of this review is the overall functionality. Let's go ahead and start off with the health tracking features. So during my time with the watch, I felt like it was accurately measuring my steps. I'm going to link a card above to someone's video where they're using an actual clicker and measuring, I think, like 8,000 steps. And the watch kept up pretty good with that person's physical clicker. So in my opinion, I think the step tracking on this watch is excellent. Now, moving on to the heart rate sensor, I feel like you get varied results throughout the day. And I think this is because you're constantly moving and sometimes your wrist isn't really in a resting spot where it can get an accurate measurement. However, if you want to get a measurement throughout the day and you stay still enough, I think you can get a very accurate measurement. And if you're working out and you want to get the most accurate results, I definitely suggest getting a chest strap monitor. You're going to get the best results with one of those. And then finally, I use it as a sleep tracker, and I feel like I did a pretty good job measuring my sleep activity. Now, I do have a 7-month-old, so I don't get the best of sleep, but those precious hours that I do get, I would like to know how well I slept. Now, let's go ahead and talk about the always-on display, which I think is an excellent feature to have on a watch. However, since I have the 40mm version, I had about 20% of battery remaining at the end of the day, and I was using it for about 15 to 16 hours per day. And since I also wanted the watch to track my sleeping activity, I knew this wasn't going to be an optimal situation. So after turning off the always-on display, I was getting about a day and a half of battery life. So to sum it up, if you do want the watch to track your sleeping at night, I would definitely turn off always-on display. This really goes for the smaller version. I think the larger version, since it has a bigger battery, it's going to last you about a day and a half with always-on display turned on anyways. But for the smaller one, definitely turn it off if you want it to preserve your battery life. And since I'm not a big outdoor runner, I didn't have enough time to really fully test out the GPS capabilities. I have seen videos where people were complaining that it's not as accurate as it should be. I know Samsung pushed out an update a couple weeks ago which fixed some of the issues, and I'll link a card above to someone who's actually been able to thoroughly test out the GPS feature. Now, let's go ahead and talk about Bixby, since this is a service that Samsung has been pushing on its devices for the last several years now, and I still feel like this is a service where Samsung really needs to improve upon. I feel like Google Assistant really set the bar of what a personal voice assistant can be, and Bixby is not that. What Bixby can do though is it can allow you to go hands-free and set up certain settings in the watch, like increase or decrease the screen brightness or put it in good night mode. It can even calculate simple formulas. In my testing though, sometimes it was sluggish to react to my voice. Other times it worked really well. So Bixby for me is still a hit or miss, and I really hope that Samsung improves this feature because it can be something beneficial for Galaxy Watch owners in the future. And lastly, let's talk about the capabilities of this watch integrating into your daily life. eye from morning, noon, and night. And what I mean by this is that you have several thousands of watch faces to choose from in the Galaxy App Store. So if you're going out on the town or going to work out, you really have unlimited possibilities to tailor this watch to your active lifestyle. So to summarize my review of the Galaxy Watch Active 2, I think it's a great watch. I think it does a lot of things really well. There are some things that Samsung can improve upon, like Bixby and maybe offering other color options in the aluminum version. But other than that, I think it's a great watch. And if you own a Galaxy phone or any Android phone, I think this is a great watch to pick up for this holiday season. And if you own an iPhone and you're interested in this watch, I'm going to link a video in the card above where I discuss the benefits and drawbacks of owning a Galaxy Watch Active 2 with an iPhone. So check that out if you're interested in that. Otherwise, this is Tech Jungle, and I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, leave a like and comment below and let me know if you're going to pick up a Galaxy Watch Active 2 and what phone are you using with it. Again, thanks for stopping by. I'll see y'all in the next video. Y'all take care.